Welcome to the React Timeline tutorial. The Syncfusion React Timeline component enables users to display a series of data in chronological order, providing a visually compelling and user-friendly experience. This showcases user activities, tracking progress, narrating historical timelines, and more. In this video, I will show you how to create a React app and add the Syncfusion React Timeline component. I will also show you how to add, align, and disable items, change the orientation, and reverse the timeline. Before proceeding, make sure you have installed the latest versions of Node.js and React. I'll be using Visual Studio Code as my editor and showing the output in the Chrome browser. First, I open Visual Studio Code and create a new React app using the command npx create React app. I name it my React app. Since I want to create the app with TypeScript, I add the template TypeScript. Next, I navigate to the newly created React app. To use the timeline component, I type the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2react-layouts --save to install the package. Before using a Syncfusion component, I need to register a trial license key. I open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. For instructions on how to generate a trial key, refer to the link in this video's description. Next, I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. I import the timeline component from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Layouts package and add the timeline component tag inside the division tag. To add items, I need to add the items directive tag, which receives n number of item directive tags. Here, I am going to add 4 items, so I add 4 tags. To use these items directive and item directive tags, import them from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Layouts package. Next, I need to add the CSS reference for the timeline component. I open the app.css file, remove the default code, and add the material theme references. To align the component, I define this tile's height, width, and margin. Now, let me save the changes and run the application using the npm start command. You can see the timeline component rendered without any content. To add the content, I set the content property to the appropriate text in the item directive tags. See, the items are displayed with the provided content. You can also display additional information about the items using the opposite content property. This will display the additional information on the opposite side of the content. To demonstrate, I add the opposite content property and set appropriate values for each item. Here, I have set the date time on the opposite side of the content. Look now, each item in the timeline component displays additional information. To customize the appearance of the timeline items, use the CSS class and .css properties. To display the success status in the first item, set the .css property to state success. I set the CSS class property to completed. Here, state success and completed are custom classes that add necessary styles to display the completion status. Likewise, I add the .css and CSS class properties for the next 2 item directive tags and set the appropriate classes. Then, I define some CSS styles to customize the appearance of the items in the app.css file. See, the timeline component items are customized as specified. The first and second items display the completion status, and the third item displays the progress status. By default, the timeline component is rendered in the vertical direction. To change this, I set the orientation property to horizontal. As you can see, the timeline component is now rendered in the horizontal direction. By default, the timeline items are aligned in the after position. Items are also aligned in before, alternate, and alternate reverse positions. Now, I am going to display the content in alternate alignment. So, I add the align property and set the value to alternate. For clarity, I change the orientation property to vertical. Checking now, the content is displayed in the alternate order. To disable the items, use the disabled property. Here, I'm going to disable the fourth item. So, I set the disabled property to true in the fourth item directive tag. Now, the fourth item is disabled in the component. Finally, I will show you how to reverse items in the timeline component. To demonstrate, I enable the reverse property in the timeline component tag. Now, the timeline is rendered in the reverse order. In this video, I have shown you how to add the Syncfusion React Timeline component to a React application. I also showed you a few of its basic features. If you want to try out the example used in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link to learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React suite through our community license if you are eligible. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please like and subscribe to our channel.